Welcome to this deeper dive into string text mining. The string database is a database of protein interactions that are compiled by integrating a wide range of different evidence types, including computational predictions, experimental data, and text mining. If you're not already familiar with string, I strongly recommend that you go watch my separate brief introduction video to the string database. Text mining is, as I said, only one source. However, it is the most important source. And I mean that from a quantitative standpoint. It is the largest source of evidence we have in the string database. In this video, I will give you a concise overview of what we mine, how we find names in text, and how we find interactions. Finally, I'll talk a little bit about how we score the interactions that we obtain from text mining. Let's start with the text corpus, what we mine. The starting point is the biomedical literature, which, if you were to print it all out, would be a pile of more than 10 kilometers of text. However, we cannot mine everything because of publisher paywalls. You cannot mine what you don't have access to. So in reality, what we are mining are PubMed abstracts, as well as full text articles whenever they are available from PubMed Central under Open Access license. We also filter the corpus to include only papers published in English, exclude retracted articles, exclude papers from paper mills, and exclude papers that are long lists of gene and protein names, such as what you would find in early sequencing projects that tended to list all genes in a certain chromosome of an organism, or even all genes in an entire genome. Once we have the corpus in place, we can start doing so-called named entity recognition. For that, we use the tagger software that was developed in my group. It does flexible matching of a biomedical dictionary against the text, thereby marking up many different types of biomedical entities. The ones that are of interest to string is species name recognition, which allows us to identify the relevant string species for which to look for gene and protein names. And then we look for gene and protein names. For this, we make use of synonyms to get good recall, that is, identify many matches, and to also get good precision, we use a regular expression to identify certain patterns of bad names, a block list of known bad names, and these bad names were originally found by manual curation. The reason why this is bad news is that that's a lot of work, so we've now changed to a different approach. What we're using is three different named entity recognition tools that identify multiple different entity types. This allowed us to define a high-quality consensus, then mask these names, and fine-tune a transformer, that is, a language model, to predict the entity type based on textual context. This allows us to predict good and bad matches by looking only at the context, not the names, and then using a scoring scheme to identify which are the bad names, that is, names that typically appear in a context that doesn't suggest that it is the entity type that our dictionary says. With named entity recognition done, we can turn our attention to interactions, and I'll start with physical interactions. For this, we build upon named entity recognition and use a large language model for finding explicit statements in text, such as this one, that says that two proteins or complexes bind or physically interact with each other. For this purpose, we mask the entity names and use a RoBERTa model that has been fine-tuned for the task using the ComplexTome corpus. If you want to learn more about large language models and fine-tuning of them, I've already covered that topic in a separate presentation. This model gives us a score per statement, and we can then calibrate that on the complex portal dataset, which is a database of protein complexes, to obtain posterior probabilities for the individual statements. We then take the best, strongest scoring statement within each article and further aggregate those over all the documents in the corpus to obtain our final confidence score of physical interaction from text mining. In string version 12.5, we will further have regulatory interactions thanks to a new fine-tuned model created on the RegulaTome corpus. If you want to learn more about that corpus and the ComplexTome corpus, watch my earlier video on the Jensen Lab corpora. This gives us a directed string network that further, in addition to having direction, has sign on the interaction so we know which are positive and negative regulatory interactions, and will have regulatory interactions both at the level of expression and post-translational regulation. This will give us the most comprehensive regulatory network and will also help keep string the best network database in the world. Speaking of being comprehensive, we also have functional associations, text mined from the literature using a co-mentioning pipeline. This pipeline counts up how many times any two proteins are mentioned together in the literature, counting both at the level of documents, paragraphs, and sentences. We combine this into a single weighted count that puts more weight on the stronger evidence being in the same sentence versus the weaker evidence being in just the same document. We do frequency normalization of these weighted counts to correct for the literature biases that we know are there. For example, P53 will be mentioned a lot more than a poorly studied protein. This approach is remarkably powerful because it's able to extract all relationship types, not just physical or regulatory interactions. On top of that, the statistical nature of the approach gives you a literature consensus. So for something to be strong, it has to be mentioned many times. The downside is that it is unspecified type. We know that two things are mentioned together a lot, so they probably do something together, but we don't know what. For this reason, we also include the large language model results. That is, we take physical interactions and regulatory interactions, and we consider them part of the functional association network because they are indeed special cases of functional associations. That's all I have to say about the text mining in string. I hope you found this interesting. If you want to learn more about other details in string, I suggest you take a look at this presentation next. Thanks for your attention.